Let's talk to Sharon next in Greenville, South Carolina. Hi, Sharon. Yeah, there's.
Hi. I wanted to ask you, my daughter has started going to what I call a user-friendly church with the tattoos and the different color hairs and the holes in the jeans and the lights blinking and the guitar screeching. And the youth director came in the other day with beer in his hand and told him there was nothing wrong with drinking as long as you didn't overdo it. Do you think the Bible really does come into saying that alcohol is a sin?
You know, I think we had to start with something that's far more foundational here. I think as Christians, we are called to be cultural initiators, not cultural imitators. And I think what we're trying to do today is with the skinny jeans and all the things that you have just mentioned, and I wear skinny jeans too from time to time, and for Pete's sake, I'm 66, but it's all a matter of propriety. I think to emulate the culture is really the wrong way to go. What people are truly looking for today, they're looking for authentic. And millennials in particular, they're looking for the real deal. And this is why you have seen so many people going into churches like the Orthodox Church, because they're searching for something above and beyond themselves. I mean, if you've been in the world long enough, you recognize, well, the world has its good points. But after all, who wants to emulate the world? We are citizens of the kingdom of God, what Augustine called the city of God. And we don't want to emulate the city of man. Now, as far as drinking in general is concerned, the truth of the matter is, we are not to be wine bibbers, we're not to be drunkards, and we're not to be gluttons. What does that mean? Too much wine, bad. But the Bible never tells us we can't have any wine. Too much food, bad. But the Bible never tells us that we can't have any food. You can fast for a while, but if you fast too long, the heart grows weary. So a little wine is good for your stomach, as Paul told Timothy. It's even medicinal in some sense. But don't ever overdo it, because we should never be in an altered state of consciousness. When you're in an altered state of consciousness, you do and say things you wouldn't normally do. So here you go to a church with a beer in your hand and you don't have a filter. That's a prescription for disaster. So all of this stuff trying to emulate being hip. Look, if people want to go to a real party, church probably not the place to go to. If you want to have a real experience, fellowship in the Trinity, I mean, find a healthy, well-balanced church.